the hands-free enterprise. A few weeks ago, I talked about that at Connect to Innovate. Now our lab is parked just in front of our office. You can see over there. And here's the lab. Let's get inside, because it's cold. What is a hands-free enterprise? Is it a future of the user experience? How does the future UI look like? How does the UI of an intelligent enterprise look like? Do you know that? Do I know that? Is it something like this? Did that look familiar? That was me, acting in a movie some years ago. No, just kidding. It was of course Tom Cruise, working in the Minority Report, and he was standing in his own user interface. He was moving around all the objects and diving into all the information that he could get on his case. What would a future UI look like? You know me, I'm not a futurist. So, I do not have a crystal ball to... Well... That will be very convenient to have such a device to predict the future. But back to the UI. Back to the SAP UI. We can do way better. How to bring intelligence to the UI? We already used to talk to Siri, to Alexa, to Google, to give us a reply on a question that we have. Hoe warm is it?
Het is nu 6 graden.
Are you ready to talk to SAP? Say I'm working for sales. And I want to know all the open quotations for a specific customer. Of course, I can open the Fiori application to give me that information. But I can also ask SAP. SAP Copilot, our digital assistant. Let me show you. Let's open Copilot. Today I'm Kate and I'm looking for all open quotations. Show open quotations for Top Bike.
Here's what I found for sales quotations with overall status open and sold to party Top Bike.
Create a standard order for the first one.
Should I create the sales order for sales order type, standard order, and reference document 20,293? Shall I continue?
Yes. Now that's handy. Now you have SAP actually listening to you and giving you the answer that you want. And it's even more handy if you have Copilot installed on your mobile phone, and when you're on the road, you can also ask Copilot for questions to give you the information. Now, if you combine chatbots, digital assistants like Copilot, together in a customer scenario, how would that look like? Well, since Recast.ai recently joined the SAP family, that's quite easy to achieve. Let's look at this customer scenario where I want to order a gift for my friend. The shop is opened, it's a jewelry shop. It's almost Christmas time, so nice time to shop something for my wife. Again, let's talk to SAP. Hi.
Hi Bernard, thank you for being a Value Jewelry Shop Club member. How can I help?
I want to buy a gift for my friend.
Okay, let me ask you some questions to find the right gift. What is your budget?
Well, 120.
And what type of gift would you like?
Now I can look in the chat functionality, I can look and can browse to the possibilities. And I think this charm is quite nice.
And which material for the charm? Okay, great. Have a look at these.
The chatbot now finds out what kind of gift I want to buy. Now it opens in the webshop all the gifts that are matching my requirements. Nice one. And I think I like the Mother's Rose. I like Mother's Rose.
An excellent choice. Will I add Mother's Rose to your cart?
Yes.
Is there anything else I can help you with?
You see, this is how a chatbot supports you in a customer-facing scenario. Digital assistants and chatbots will change the way we interact with systems. It is predicted that by 2020 we will have 85% of scenarios handled by chatbots in customer interaction scenarios. I think that helps in the user interface. It helps in the user friendliness, because now instead of searching for possibilities, we can just ask. What about smart devices? What if you add intelligence to devices? Say I'm working as an engineer, I'm working on project locations and I need to take equipment and materials with me to do my job. I'm going into the warehouse and need to find the right tool for my job. But I do not like the administrative hassle that comes with that. So my iPad to the rescue. Here's my project, and I need to have an equipment, I need to find an equipment in the warehouse. It's this one. And what if I can use image of text recognition to support me with that? The label is scanned. I say okay. And now it gives me the options. Okay, this item that you just scanned is not available, but the others are. So I can now replace the equipment. And then when I'm done with my job and I need to return materials to the warehouse, can I also include intelligence to that process? Yes, you can. This material, what if we do image recognition for them? Open the app again. And it now identifies this piece as a corner piece with a 90 degrees and a pressure for 300. And I say yes. And it comes over here in my list. I can confirm. And now it will be returned to the warehouse. Less administrative hassle, and that saves me a lot of time. There's also another example, but for that I would like to take you to the elevator. What about smart shoes? What if I'm a technician responsible for maintaining elevators? My shoes then can warn me if I'm approaching the elevator shaft too close, so that prevents me from falling into it. Thanks to my smart shoes. Back to the lab. Augmented and virtual reality, a new way to support the end user. With augmented reality, we can place virtual objects in the real world. How can this help me as an end user? Well, for example, I want to have a new floor in our mobile innovation lab. In the app that we created, you can first select the floor. Now when I'm ready, I can change the floor to something blue, maybe a wooden floor. So now I can have a preview on how this floor will look like in our lab. This will make the life of in-house architects easier, but also for customers so they can have a preview of their new floor. Now, I showed you the co-pilot, our digital assistant, I showed you chatbots, I showed you some smart devices, some little bit of AR. Are these all future possibilities? Future scenarios? No, these are all possible today with our intelligent technologies. You can build them yourself. What is a future scenario? Will we go back to handwriting? Handwriting is the most natural way to interact with the backend. You write down your question and you'll get the results on your tablet. You don't want a color? Delete it and get a new one. SAP InScribe is a new way to do live analytics and is available in the near future. Now I'm wondering what the future will bring us on the user interface area. Will it be a smart device? That when I put it on my head, it will read my mind and will then know what I'm looking for and give me an answer in my ears? Scary or very handy? There is a lot possible with new technologies. Let's use those possibilities. We're only limited by our own imagination. Be creative and support the end user because they deserve it. See you next time. Oh, one thing. I do want to thank my colleagues at Solution Experience for the demos of the Smart Jewelry Shop and also for the Copilot. And the demo that I did with machine learning and image recognition was with GasUni, built in our Mobile Innovation Lab. And the demo with the floor changing app was built for Forbo Flooring Systems together with partners Quinzo and Twinkles. See you next time.